High fives, then I'm out the door, I'm on my phone. I escape to a room and sing my song to myself, cause I don't wanna sing it wrong. St. Louis hyperpop duo Frost Children have released their second full-length album, Speedrun. I had not heard of Frost Children until this year, but with the release of several catchy singles, I was anticipating what this album might sound like. The album contains lots of glitchy and dancey pop music, but is more mixed than I would have liked. The album begins with the track Coup, which has a catchy, profanity-laced chorus. However, the verses kind of drag, and lyrically, I don't find the song all that interesting. Like, the coup seems to be that the person they wanted didn't return the affection, which sounds more like rejection than a coup. The next song, Flatline, has the same rhythm as the previous song, Coup, and it also continues with the next song, Sick Trip. It's just a beat and snare combo over and over again. Do-ka, do-ka, do-ka. And I guess if you're into that kind of club sound, you will love this. But three songs of this in a row, I was just kind of over it. Lyrically, Flatline seems to be about loving someone so much that you go stupid. Which is fine in concept, but then some of the other verses of this song leave me feeling kind of confused. Like, at one point, they sing, "Step away, I could feel your disease." And like, what disease? Like, I thought this was about love making you stupid, and now you're diseased? Like, is it stupiditis? I don't understand what's happening here. Musically, though, it is more of a club banger, and I could see people, like, losing their minds on the dance floor to this, which is fun if that's what you're into. Sick Trip is another club song, and I just find it more boring than the other two. We then get the song All I Got, which still kind of has that club beat sound with the kick and the snare, but it's slightly more subdued than the other three songs, so it feels like things are starting to diversify. The music for All I Got is way more interesting, with these glitchy, almost bubble-like sounds. And lyrically, the song is pretty straightforward. It's about giving everything to someone, but it just hits so much harder. It is a fun bubblegum pop sound that is just delicious and radio-friendly. The song Obsessed is a mess. There is so much going on in this song, and not all of it works. I mean, some of it is good. It's just, as I said, it's a mess. We get these almost screamo-like vocals where they yell about how obsessed they are. We even get some blast beats in the song. As if this is a metal dance song. But in the end, I feel like I'm left way more confused than I am entertained by this song. The next song, Serpent, is just a straight-up screamo song, and in my opinion, it's not even a good screamo song. However, this is followed up by the incredible song High Five. It is this glitchy pop song that sounds almost like it samples old-school video games. With the singing on this song matching the intensity, it's just a fun, dancey pop banger. The song Let It Be features Exum? I'm not sure how to pronounce it, so sorry if I mispronounced it. And it's an okay song. The song itself is a fast-paced hyperpop song, while Exum kind of raps on the track. Although I'm not a huge fan of Exum's first half of the verse, they do it as if they can't breathe, or if they got like some phlegm in their throat. And I guess it was done intentionally, but I just feel like I want to give them water or something. The song then turns into this light, bubbly pop tune near the end that I find much more enjoyable than the first half of this song. The song, Angel's Thoughts, is again an okay song, but lyrically I find it kind of cringy. It seems to be about liking decadent things, such as high fashion. At one point, Angel sings they wear Mew Mew, looking like Mewtwo, the Pokemon, and like, I don't know, cool, I guess. Wonderland is a really chill song featuring Blake the Man 1000 and May Rio. The lyrics here are, again, kind of cringy to me. Like, it's a love song, but they're mixing in Alice in Wonderland references, and I guess that's cool. Even the Blake the Man verse, they speak about themselves in the third person, which is an odd choice. May Rio's backing vocals throughout the track, though, are wonderful. The album ends with the song Notice Me, featuring 8485 or 8485. I'm not sure what their name is, but it's just those numbers, 8485. Musically, it is a decent song. It is a bit more cinematic with string synths. It has some of the more interesting lyrical moments here, with lines like, why does my pain help you fucking live? That line comes in with this epic musical finale, which would have made for a brilliant conclusion on a better album, honestly. I really wanted to love this album, and there are moments here that stand out as being wonderfully composed masterpieces. But there are also moments here that felt awkward and somewhat superficial. That being said, musically, this album is fun, and it doesn't take itself too seriously. And so if you want to jam and just have a dance party, this album might just be what you're looking for. I do think Frost Children have the talent to make a killer album, and I will look forward to what they produce in the future. However, with this album, I would have to give it a 6 out of 10. So thank you for listening, and let me know if you like this album. Let me know if you agreed with me and it wasn't as good as it could have been. Like, it wasn't terrible, but it just wasn't as good as it could have been. And, you know, like the video if you want, subscribe. It'll help my channel grow, and then maybe you'll get to see more of, oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh my god. Her nails are hurting me so much. Oh my god. This is my cat, Simone.